Welcome to the IVM Podcast Network.
TFG Interviews is an IVM production, and you can also check out their other awesome shows like Simplified, a show that explains intense topic from around the world and simplifies it for you so that you can appear cooler in front of your friends.
You're listening to TFG Interviews.
Welcome everyone, it's raining in Mumbai and it's raining interviews at the TFG Interviews podcast. Today we have a couple of BFC players, Bengaluru FC. Sijo is in Bangalore and she's met up with a couple of players and we will be talking to, we will be hearing them talk to Sijo, the two players that we will be getting to on today's podcast are, one is Nishu Kumar. He plays as a left back and he's not even 20, you know. That's the potential he has, and he's an upcoming star for Bengaluru FC and a potential left back for India under 23 or, you know, even in the senior national side down the line. And another player that we'll be talking to is Collin Abranches, who's also part of the BFC squad. Both these players are very young, and it's a great opportunity for Sijo to get in talking terms with them and to know what they are, what their plans is. So Sijo, would you like to tell something about Nishu Kumar, the left back? Yeah. You know, he was promising player, upcoming for the team.
Yeah, actually, just like you started saying, it's raining in Bombay for a change, and you know, for a surprise, Bangalore is dry today. Otherwise, you know, the whole last week was raining bad over here. So, yeah, I mean, coming back to the interview bit, I was fortunate enough to meet and talk to these two young stars, we should call them, from Bengaluru FC. Nishu Kumar, of course, a fan favorite. He's someone who's always, whenever he's on the pitch and the Facebook Blues are behind him, you know, backing him and supporting him, and whether even he plays for under 23 as well. So this interview, as we know, he's a young kid. He speaks in Hindi because we thought, you know, let's make the player comfortable. Let's make him comfortable. So he was so the interview is in Hindi, and we talk about his BFC journey. He's been here since 2015, and he was retained again. He's looking, he's pretty much looking forward to play in the ISL. And since now the team is, as just like he says, you know, just, the team is new now. There's a bit more competition. He also talks about all of that and his experience in under 23 in Qatar that they had. So yeah, I think let's listen in to Nishu Kumar.
Yeah, let's go into the clip.
So Nishu, you've been with Bengaluru since 2015, and once again they put the trust in you. They've retained you for the upcoming season, and now Bengaluru are going to be in ISL. So how has been, can you take us through how is the experience with BFC and now what are you looking forward to for ISL?
Actually, this is my first professional club. First year, mere ko jyada chance nahi mila. So the last season, coach change hua, to mere ko usne trust kiya, coach ne trust kiya, and main achha khela. And I hope ki ISL mein mera same performance rahe.
और आपका रिलेशनशिप कैसा है टीम से? अभी टीम में बड़े बड़े प्लेयर्स हैं, मीन लेजेंडरी प्लेयर्स नील छेत्री सब है, और आप फर्स्ट सीजन से उनके साथ खेल रहे हो, ट्रेनिंग में साथ हो, अभी और आपको वक्त मिलेगा, आपको वक्त बिताने को, तो आपका एक्सपीरियंस कैसा है, रिलेशन कैसा है छेत्री के साथ?
टीम के साथ मेरा बहुत अच्छा रिलेशनशिप है, एंड मैं लक्की फील करता हूँ कि मेरे को इंडिया टीम के ऐसे सीनियर प्लेयर मिला, जैसे सुनील भाई, उदांता, गुरप्रीत भाई, ये सब, इनसे काफ़ी कुछ सीखने को मिलता है, एंड टीम के साथ मेरा अच्छा रिलेशनशिप है, और वो लोग काफ़ी मेरे को गाइड करते हैं. और
अब सीनियर नेशनल टीम का भी कैंप में थे म्यांमार और किर्गिस्तान में, तो थोड़ा बहुत शेयर करेंगे कॉन्स्टेंटाइन एज अ कोच कैसे, और अब अंडर 23 भी उनके वही कोच करते हैं, अंडर 23 स्क्वाड को, तो कैसे उनके साथ रिलेशन?
इधर से थोड़ा डिफरेंट है, उधर नेशनल टीम में कॉन्स्टेंटाइन के अंदर, एंड यहाँ पे मैं लेफ्ट बैक खेल रहा हूँ, सो नेशनल टीम में वो मेरे को राइट बैक ट्राई करता है, सो उधर मेरे को ज़्यादा चांस नहीं मिला है खेलने को, क्योंकि हम लोग बस मैं हम लोग इधर AFC मैचेस वगैरह होते थे, तो उधर कैंप में ज़्यादा टाइम नहीं मिलता था, सिर्फ दो तीन तीन चार ट्रेनिंग सेशन में उधर ट्रेन किया. सो कोच टाइन वो अच्छा कोच है, सीनियर टीम के साथ मेरे को काफ़ी कुछ सीखने को मिला, और Under-23 में मेरे को खेलने को मिला. सो आई एम हैप्पी.
और कतर में कैसा था आपका टूर जो आपने AFC Under-23 चैंपियनशिप खेला?
अच्छा, काफ़ी अच्छा एक्सपीरियंस था वो मेरे लिए, Under-23 नेशनल टीम को रिप्रेजेंट करना. एक्चुअली Under-19 में रिप्रेजेंट किया, तो सीनियर टीम के लिए रिप्रेजेंट करने का मीन्स आई एम ट्राइंग. एंड Under-23 अच्छा रहा, जो दूसरा टीम था काफ़ी स्ट्रॉन्ग था, सो उधर पता चलता है कि हम कौन से लेवल पे हैं.
अभी अब वापस अभी नए सीजन में हो BFC के साथ, एंड ISL फर्स्ट टाइम BFC खेलने वाला है, और नया कंपटीशन रहेगा, नए लोग रहेंगे नो ऑपोजिशन में, तो क्या आपका एम क्या है, गोल क्या रहेगा? आपने AFC में भी खेला है तो हाईएस्ट इन एशिया एशियन लेवल में, तो आपका अभी BFC के साथ भी क्या गोल है? आप उन्होंने आपके ऊपर ट्रस्ट किया, अभी आप कैसे ये करोगे?
हाँ, एक्चुअली अभी पूरा टीम चेंज हो गया है, सो अभी कंपटीशन ज़्यादा हो गया है, तो फर्स्ट मैं ट्राई करूँगा कि मैं ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा मैचेस खेलने को मिले, और लास्ट टाइम से बेटर खेलूँ मैं, तो आई ट्राई माय बेस्ट. या
आपको फैंस कैसा लग रहा है वेस्ट ब्लॉक ब्लूज? आप फैन फेवरेट हो, वन ऑफ द नेम्स जो लाउड एंड यू नो क्लियर सुना देते हैं, चांस है आपके साथ, आपका फैंस के साथ कैसा रिलेशन है, सपोर्ट कैसा है?
या फैंस की वजह से काफ़ी मोटिवेट होते हैं, और मीन्स बहुत मोटिवेट होते हैं हम फैंस जब वार्म अप के लिए जाते हैं मैच से पहले, और फैन लाइक फैन बहुत अच्छे हैं. मीन्स मैं बहुत लक्की वो करता हूँ कि मेरे को बेंगलोर में खेलने को मिला, और वेस्ट ब्लॉक ब्लूज वो इतना सपोर्ट करते हैं, और जब वो चैंट करते हैं तो मेरे को बहुत अच्छा लगता है.
फाइनल इसमें आप ज़्यादा प्लेइंग टाइम नहीं मिला है, लेकिन आप ये कर रहे हो कि आपको ज़्यादा मिले, तो अब तक का आपका फेवरेट मोमेंट क्या रहेगा, मतलब जो आपकी शॉर्ट प्लेइंग करियर है अब तक?
फेवरेट मोमेंट जब हम इधर सेमीफाइनल AFC सेमीफाइनल जौहर के साथ हम जीता था 3-1, वो मेरा फेवरेट मोमेंट था, क्योंकि उस टाइम बहुत पब्लिक आया था, तो वो मेरा फेवरेट मोमेंट है. और जब मैं इस क्लब में साइन किया था, दैट वाज माय फेवरेट.
एनीथिंग आर यू लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू? ISL में क्या एक्सपेक्टेशंस है आपको, टीम से या आप खुद से?
ये मेरा फर्स्ट ISL है, तो एज अ टीम हम लोग अच्छा परफॉर्म करना चाहेंगे इसमें ISL में, और मैं अपना बेस्ट देना चाहता हूँ इस ISL में, क्योंकि ये मेरा फर्स्ट ISL है. सो थैंक यू
सो मच.
So that was Nishu Kumar, the left back, and we have another player from the BFC camp. It's Collin Abranches. You did get to talk to him as well. Young and upcoming player. And what does he have to say, Siju? What did you all talk about?
Yeah, so he's 25 years old, and he was picked by Bengaluru during the draft this season that they had. So he was very much surprised, and in fact, very much happy to know that he was picked by Bengaluru. And he's looking forward to play for them. He talks about how the preseason training went about in Spain, sharing the dressing room with big names, and the style of football that Roca likes, and he is also looking forward for that. Like he's, what do you say, Roca has a bit touch of Barcelona style of footballing, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's what Colin likes about it, and he, because even he, growing up, looked up to the style of, how Barcelona played, and he also reveals who was his idol that he looks up to.
Oh.
And I think I won't reveal it. Let's see her what Colin has to say.
So Colin, could you take us through your journey? I mean, footballing days and till you could come to BFC.
I started with Mahindra Youth Academy, and I was under Santosh Kashyap for almost 6 years, and then. The first downfall happened when they shut their senior team. That's when I was picked up in the senior team, was shut that year. And it was quite difficult, but then Air India showed a lot of interest, as well as Salgaonkar, but then I chose a smaller team so I could get chance to play. So I was in Air India for 2 years, then I moved to Salgaonkar. It was good there, playing under Karim. And then I chose Calcutta to see the experience there, which was also good. I was in Mohammedan the year we played the I-League. And then I had a very major injury on my knee. So that's when things started getting a little difficult for me. And yeah, I had a lot of offers till then, but then once I hurt my leg, you know, everything went away. And then I joined Ozone last season. No, after my injury, I was in Mumbai FC. Things were not so well there and so organized, so it became difficult for me there. And then I moved to Ozone. I had a good season in Ozone, but still we couldn't qualify in the second division. And then it was draft day again for me, and I had no idea Bangalore FC would pick me. And so then I got a call from my best friend's mom saying that you're picked by Bangalore, because I was on a picnic that day because I didn't want to watch the draft. And yeah, overnight things changed. I had to leave the next day, come to Bangalore. It was a very proud moment for me, because when Ashley was the coach here, I had a lot of offers from past 2 years from him, and I always looked forward to come to Bangalore FC because it was very professional. The fans are good. Like, it felt home the day he called me only. So I always looked forward to come to Bangalore. When I was in Ozone, I used to just look forward to come to Bangalore, and things worked out.
So now, since you've been here, I mean, now except the AFC Cup, nothing has much started off. So, but take us through if you can share something about your experience in training, with sharing the dressing room with players who have been there, done that.
Yeah. See, I used to meet Sunil Bhai last year because I'm a good friend with Keegan. So I used to meet Sunil Bhai, and it was unbelievable to come here and share the dressing room with him. Yeah. So the first few days in training was getting a little nervous, you know, things were very different. But then once I got to know everyone, like, I'm pretty close with Eric, Rahul, so like the Goan boys, and playing alongside players like this, it's really good. I've learned a lot being here just a month now. You know, football is very fast here. It's very, like, you need to be very strong mentally, physically. So yeah, things have changed in 1 month for me.
How is you've been part of a lot of clubs and you have different coaches everywhere.
Yeah.
So how is Roka like as a coach?
For me, it's not because I'm here I'm going to say Roka is a good coach, but I like Barcelona style of football. So I always looked forward to play this style of football, because whenever I used to be in other clubs, you know, it was just direct football, which wasn't so good for me because I'm not so physical in direct football. So the day I came here, I got to know last year only that, you know, the style of football over here, Spanish style, is always keeping the ball. So the day I came here, I came with a mindset of, you know, playing the Barcelona style, because I've heard that Roca sir likes the Barcelona style. So yeah, he's a very good coach. If you listen to him and do what he wants, I think you can move a step forward with him, as well as the assistant coach, as well as all the other coaches over here. You know, they all have the same mindset, so it gets a little easier for me to implement what they want me to. And I've always followed Barcelona football, so it made me get easy to this style.
Yeah. How was your pre-season training just now, because you were also a new entrant to the team and there were many other new faces around, so how was that like?
The preseason, I guess, helped us a lot this year. It was just 10 days, but we used to have 2 sessions, and we used to interact with the players a lot more. I've learned a lot of style of football there and what coach wants you to do. I've learned his style over there. So, and plus I've got game time, so which was very important for me. So I knew exactly what he wanted. And I think the preseason actually helped me a lot to know what he wants and the style of football. And many players who have played in Bangalore FC last year, they have also helped me by talking to me and telling me, like, you know, what he wants and what he, like, Sunil Bhai has spoken to me a lot. So that's helped me a lot now.
Is it, if, while growing up, Ona, you said you liked Barcelona style of
yeah.
player. Any player that you look up to and you want
I
to?
Always looked up to Dani Alves, yeah. Yeah, he was one, like, he's an idol. His type of football is, like, physical also and smart football. So I've always looked up to him.
Now, Bengaluru are going to be part of ISL, and you must be like, you of course know, I mean, everyone knows about ISL, the glamour, the
yeah.
all the attention that it gets and everything around. So, looking forward to a new competition, how do you look at it?
Glamour is all over football now. Once the ISL started, you know, it's getting into the I-League also, and it's not going to be anything new for Bangalore, I guess, because Bengaluru always had that glamour and, you know, like fans, support from all around the, you know, people know Bangalore players more than any other I-League clubs. So I don't think, I'm looking forward to play big clubs now, you know, play against Calcutta in the ISL, play against Kerala. So that's going to be a nice challenge for me.
Hmm. Yeah. Now, would you want to, like, if, I mean, it's you're just a start over here, but I'm just still asking, would you want to stay here for a very long time and groom yourself and probably want a shot at, of course, Indian national team is something everyone's looking at.
See, I was very unlucky in my career because I've never got a team that I could stay in.
Hmm.
You know, it was always teams that were not sure of staying in the competition. So, Bengaluru, coming to Bengaluru FC, I have always, yeah, the time I signed, I hope I had got a 3-year or 4-year contract with Bangalore. But definitely, I look forward to staying with Bangalore since they have this one style of, you know, doing everything and everything's the right way. So, I definitely look forward to being a part of Bengaluru FC for a long time.
Any thoughts on the fans that are there? Less in number, but always loud and vocal.
Yeah, the fans are crazy, man. The fans are crazy here. I've always seen the fans, and yeah, they are less number, but they are crazy people, man. Nothing else to say about them, but it feels good.
So is this the loudest that you've heard the fans being, because you've been played like played
yeah
in Calcutta as well?
This, it's pretty, yeah, it is loud for this number, this many number of people they have. But yeah, I've played in Mohammedan also, and those were when the stands were pretty full. So yeah, but they were not so loud also.
So what can we expect from Collin for the coming season?
I just hope I get a good chance over here to prove myself. You know, I'm going to work hard in Bengaluru and try to make a place in the 11 and, you know, keep being consistent. And I just hope for the best and hope to give the best I can to Bengaluru FC so that they remember me in the future.
Yeah, those were the two players of BFC that Siju spoke to. And we've also spoken to other players from the BFC. We're not talking about anyone else but Sunil Chetri. If you want to hear Siju's conversation with Sunil Chetri, you'll have to search a bit. And if you do a search, it's...
And also the Flash. Don't forget Mr. Flash on our show.
Oh, yes. He just goes so quickly, it's difficult to catch and remember
yeah.
him. Yeah, so lots of BFC players interviewed by Siju. You can grab hold of those podcasts that have happened in the recent past. Udanta was just last week, and Sunil Chetri was a bit you know, towards the
in
last
March.
AFC camp. Camp. Yeah,
yeah, it was in.
Yeah, so that was a fun conversation to listen to again. So that was it for today's edition of the TFG Interview Podcast, and we will keep getting you more and more. Till then, if you're listening to us on YouTube, do not forget to like, share, subscribe, and also do not forget to comment. And if you're listening to us on your Android phone, do not forget to download IVM Podcast app for many such shows, just like the TFG Podcast and TFG Interviews. You'll get you can find the IVM Podcast app on Android and iOS as well. And the podcast is also available on major podcasting apps like SoundCloud, iTunes, etc. Till another show, till another interview. Take care. Bye.
Excuse me, भैया. Excuse me.
बोले मैडम.
मेन्यू में क्या है?
मेन्यू में सीन अनसीन है, पॉडकास्ट है, ऑनकोर्स है, साइरस है, मेड इन इंडिया, रीडिस्कवरी प्रोजेक्ट, एम्पावरिंग सीरीज, सेक्स वैक्स है, आईवीएम लाइक्स है, सिंप्लीफाइड है, कीपिंग इट क्वियर है, थिंग्स एंड डेस्टिनेशंस है, माय नेबर ज़करबर्ग है और द फैन गैराज है. आपको क्या चाहिए?
एक बार रिपीट कर देंगे क्या?
रिपीट नहीं करता हम. आप जाओ ivmpodcast.com पे और सुनो ये सब, या फिर डाउनलोड करो उनका ऐप. सब आपकी उंगलियों पे.